what's a leader and what's a tippet? Well, the tippet is just the last part of your leader. It's the long, skinny part that you tie your fly onto. Let me unroll this leader and show you the parts of a leader. Now, it's all integral. It's one piece. It's a knotless, tapered leader. If I run my fingers starting at the skinny end, I can feel that it starts to get thicker right about here, and that's the tippet. So it's an integral part of the leader. Now, every time you change flies, that tippet is going to get a little bit shorter, and eventually it's going to get to the point where the tippet isn't long enough and it's going to be too thick. So in that case, you need to tie on a new tippet. So to tie on a new tippet, you run your fingers down the leader and you feel where it starts to get thicker. And then you come down a little bit to the skinny part and you tie your new tippet on there. Now, if you're not sure exactly where to tie that new tippet on, this is a 5X leader and I need a new 5X tippet. So what I'm gonna do is I'll take a piece of 5X and I've got all my sizes of tippet here. And I'll just eyeball that piece of 5X along the leader to find the point where the leader is about 5X. At that point, I'll take a new piece of tippet and I'll pull 2 to 3 feet of tippet material from my spool, cut it, and I will tie on a new piece of tippet with a surgeon's knot. Now, if you don't know how to tie a surgeon's knot, you can go to the Orvis Learning Center and see an animation on how to tie a surgeon's knot. It's easier if you wet your tippet. It helps keep the two pieces together when you tie a surgeon's knot. And you just tie that new tippet on to the end of your leader. Tighten the knot. Always test your knots. Trim the ends. Be careful you cut the right piece. And don't use your teeth, use your snips. Make sure you find the right ends. And when you trim these little pieces of your leader, put them in your pocket. Don't leave them in the stream. And now you've got a leader with a brand new fresh tippet.